If I continue to wade in this tropical stream with my feet submerged, eventually my toes will become wrinkly. No one fully knows the reason for this, but there are some hypotheses. Let's look at these now. Wrinkly skin happens when we stay in water for more than about 5 minutes. Let's have a look at some reasons why this may occur. Well, the wrinkles, by increasing surface area and allowing more skin to come into contact with objects, may give us a better grip in wet conditions. That would help our ancestors when collecting food from fast-flowing waterways, underwater or damp areas. This has been researched, with some studies confirming this, but also others finding that in many cases, wrinkling does not help when handling wet objects. I guess try it next time you're in the bath and see for yourself. Our toes also wrinkle in water, and this may be to increase our feet's surface area and help us grip better onto wet surfaces. Alternatively, some scientists don't think there's any actual reason for skin wrinkling, that it's solely a mechanical response when the blood vessels under our skin constrict. However, I'm not sure about this one. Firstly, it only occurs on the hands and feet, nowhere else in the body. Secondly, it's not just a thing in humans. Wrinkly fingers also occurs in some primates, such as a macaque monkey. So it seems like something more than just a strange occurrence. With that said, there are potential benefits to wrinkly fingers. So why aren't they always that way? Well, some hypothesize that this could make them more susceptible to injury or reduce the finger's sensitivity, making it not optimal for everyday use. In addition, as the blood vessels do shrink, long-term lowered blood supply can lead to what's called trench foot, which results in swollen, painful skin, blisters, and leaves the feet far more prone to infection. Now, how does it occur? And this bit is interesting. The wrinkling of fingers and toes is not a passive process. The body specifically allows water to pass through the first few layers of skin and not the others. In fact, injury to the nervous system prevents the skin from ever wrinkling. And in the past, doctors could place a patient's hand in water and use skin wrinkling as a simple way to detect nervous system dysfunction. In order to facilitate wrinkling, the skin's nearby blood vessels are constricted. Coupled with the protective oil being washed away, the layered anatomy of the skin, and the extra area available where the blood vessels once were, an influx of water can migrate into that area. The top layers swell, while the lower layers stay intact, and the skin then bulges out into a wrinkly appearance. So, whether it's a nervous system response that enhances our ability to pick up wet objects, or simply a mechanical response to blood vessel dilation, our wrinkly skin is an interesting phenomenon that has kept scientists questioning for decades.